Greetings and Happy New Year to you and your family. I gotta tell you this one. You know, my mother doesn't stay up late at night, but she did on New Year's Eve, and the first three words that came out of her mouth were, "We made it." She was right, and it's all because of God's grace and His mercy. It's my sincere prayer that the year 2021 will open up an amazing, exciting, inspiring, God-filled chapter in all of our lives. Despite all the mess that's going on around us, our God is in control, and He will provide us everything we need for the journey ahead. In his day, the prophet Isaiah spoke encouraging words to the nation of Israel who were in captivity in Babylon. You see, Solomon's temple had been destroyed, lives were lost, there was a famine in the land, all sorts of oppression. You see, the godless Nebuchadnezzar and his troops laid siege to Jerusalem and Judah. He was bent on conquering God's people, their property, their possessions, and he utterly wanted to destroy their abiding faith and confidence in the one true God. This was a very dark chapter in the nation of Israel, and I imagine God's people had all sorts of questions. Where is God? When will He show up? And what about His power to deliver us from oppression? To be honest with you, I've had all sorts of questions during the coronavirus pandemic myself. I too want to know, when will God deliver us from COVID-19? I've stood at countless graveside services. I've seen tears flowing down mothers' cheeks. I've heard fathers raise questions. I've looked into the eyes of children and I've wept alongside them. I have questions and I'm pretty sure you do too. When will God show up and when will God rescue us? I want to tell you, even when it seems God is not at work, the truth is our God is at work. And He does His best work behind the scene. When it seemed God is not present, the Bible says God will never leave you nor forsake you. God eventually delivered His people from bondage, brought them out of captivity. Then came the reassuring, comforting, and calming words of Isaiah. Listen to what he says. Every person then and now, every person in the year 2021 who waits on God, God will bless you to make the journey. Now, when Isaiah speaks of waiting on God, he's not implying that we should do nothing or that we should be idle or that we should be lazy. He literally says, every person who submits to God, actively seeks God, actively looks to God, actively expects God to work in their lives, God will show up in wonderful ways and He will bless your life in the year to come. Here's what Isaiah said in Isaiah chapter 40, verse 31. He says, when we wait on God, when we look to God, lean on God, depend on God, call on God, count on God, Isaiah says He will renew our strength. He will energize us, rejuvenate us, supply us with His power to run on to see what the end will be. 2 Timothy chapter 1, verse 7 says, for God has not given us a spirit of fear, but of power, love, and a sound mind. You can't throw in the towel because the wind is blowing contrary. You can't give up because things don't work out your way. We can't throw in the towel because there seems to be no end to this coronavirus. God will supply us the power to make it in 2021. The God we serve has power over sickness. He has power over death. He has power over nature. He has power over personal problems. He has power over the enemy. The devil has some power, but our God has all power. And in 2021, if we trust Him and expect Him to work in our lives, He will renew our strength. Secondly, He will reset our focus. Jeremiah, the 29th chapter, verse 11 says, for I know the plans I have for you, declare the Lord, plans to prosper you and not harm you, plans to give you hope and a future. God knows everything we're going to experience in 2021. He knows every encounter, every experience. He knows every problem we'll face, every hill we'll have to cross, every valley we'll have to wade through. God knows. He will reset our focus and cause us to value the things He values. He will cause us to have the same priorities that He has. He will reset our focus so that the energy He supplies us will be to the end that we bring His name glory and honor, and we help to expand His kingdom here on earth. Not only will He reset our focus and renew our strength, but He will reward our obedience if we wait on Him. Do you know what the mark of a successful Christian life is? It's long obedience in the same direction. God calls us to obey Him even if it doesn't feel right, even if it doesn't feel good. Obey Him. Even if you're rejected, obey Him. Even if it doesn't make sense, obey Him. Even if you can't determine how it's going to turn out, obey Him. Even if it's looked bleak and dismal and dark, obey Him. Even if you can't figure it out, obey God, and He will bless your obedience. Here we are, the year 2021. It's a new year. It's a new beginning. It's a new journey, but we have the same God, and He promised to supply us with everything we need to live this year out, to bring Him glory and to bring Him honor. I pray you'll look to Him in 2021 and watch Him work powerfully in your life. May the Lord bless you and keep you in His care.